answer a question, say your name first.
Oh, beautiful, thank you.
That would be the best case scenario. Five voices can be really hard to figure out.
Yourself.
Yeah, please identify yourself before you answer the question. Coach, you want to start with an opening statement of some sort?
There's not, I mean, a whole lot to say here. I just accept the amount of pride I feel right now. We just had a great group. They battled all year long, starting in September with workouts. I can't say enough about our leadership, our senior leadership this year. They were just unbelievable. We got in the spring, and our goal was never to make it to this game. Our goal was just to get better every day, to show up at practice, work hard, and get better. And these it's a testament to these guys that they did that every day, day in and day out. They showed up and worked hard to get better. And when you do that, you can accomplish a lot of great things. I'm just so proud of these guys and everybody on the team. Everybody on the team had a role in this win. And I can't tell you the amount of pride I have just to be this, you know, this, as a coach, I feel like I'm a steward of the team, but it's really their team. And they really, bought into it. And one of our cheers is family, and we really came together as a family. I'm just so proud of these guys.
Hey Coach, talk about what was like the turning point this season where you felt like this was a special group that you guys could get to this point?
I knew we had a special group all along. We started off a little bit rocky, but that gave us a little motivation, gave us some great film to look at to get better. I don't think there really was a turning point. I think maybe the Mount Hebron win, that was a big win for us. And then coming out and really jumping over Glen Elg was a really good team. I think it really showed the guys the potential that we had as a group.
Ethan, the celebration there, Ben, I imagine you guys did not know there were 0.6 seconds still up.
Oh, yeah,
no. What was that like, just the feeling there?
Ethan Carr, that's what you say, man. But it's just kind of like something you dream of, like, as a kid, you know, like playing sports, like to win any sort of championship is just like a big deal. And you see like everyone on, like even like the most like professional athletes, like they're just full of emotion. Like us being like high school kids, winning something like this that Sherman Park is like, I guess, supposed to do like pretty often, but we haven't been able to do it in 6 years. So to bring it back to Sherman Park, it's just an amazing feeling because this group of seniors, when we came in as freshmen, the seniors then were like, yeah, you guys will probably have about 3 state championships by the time you graduate, but we haven't put in the work. Like the past 3 years of work just hasn't been there. So to have this team put in as much work as they did and for to have it end like that, it's just an amazing feeling, just kind of like a weight lifted off your shoulders bringing the trophy back.
Coach, I mean, we talked about your defense again. What can you say? I mean, that's a season low for them in goals. Did you envision holding them to 3 goals? I know you guys talk about 5 a lot of times as a benchmark, but hold them to 3.
I think that's just a tremendous job. It's a testament to our defensive coordinator, Mickey Blum, who's just done an amazing job with the group. He's a great coach, but really a testament to the players buying into what Coach is talking about. And they executed the game plan. I mean, when we went into it, we just said, guys, look, we know every move they're going to make. They know every move we're going to make. It's just a matter of who executes a little bit better. And defensively, we just pretty much done that all year.
Trevor, what was that second quarter surge like? What do you think you guys really accomplished? What were you able to do there in the second quarter to really take control of the game?
You know, I think our effort and intensity just picked up immensely. When we start going on runs a little bit, we're a team of runs. It gets the energy up on the sidelines, all the way up to the players on the field, and I think that really just helps us.
Joe, what did you say the other day? Something about keeping them off your porch, whatever, and the crease. What can you just say about, you know, to elaborate on the role that your defense play, not only in this win, but just throughout the whole entire season, especially the playoffs?
I'm Jim Morrow, by the way, and so keep it off the front porch, kind of like keep it out, like our paint pretty much in front of the goal, and as long as we can do that, they have to shoot outside, and our goalie can eat it up. Barrett's a tremendous young player, and he'll be great by the time he's a senior. And all year our defense has been, like I said, play inside out. And when you can do that, you can go out and play them and get back in, and we can help on the crease. And that's, I think, I can't put it in words how good it feels to have our defense keep teams at three goals in the state championship.
And Drew, I think one of the first goals was one that set up by you forcing a turnover. I mean, how it might not show up in the box score anywhere, but I mean, how much pride do you take in, you know, when you do something like that? You force a turnover, they go down and score.
Hey, Drew.
I take a lot of pride in it. I mean, our defense played tremendously. You know, we may not always get the stats or anything, but I mean, we know we can single-handedly turn a game around. And I mean, it was apparent in the first quarter. We just got everything rolling. Yeah.
You guys fall down 1-0, and then you score 7 straight goals over the next few quarters. What was it about that run that was working so well? Was it something you saw in Howard's defense that you guys fixed, or I mean, was there anything X's and O's that you guys figured out?
There's a little bit of X's and O's. They went zone on us, and we've had a zone offense that we've kind of been holding all year for a situation like that, and we ran it in the second half. Our second midfield came in and did a wonderful job of that. They had a great possession to finish with a goal. So it was really just kind of handling their zone. And then I think we got a couple transition goals, or we call it early offense. It may not look like a fast break right away, but we're looking to go pretty quickly. We do that every day in practice. Everything we do in practice kind of up and down. We do a lot of competition, and I think it shows when we can go on some runs.
Ethan, offensively, just I think there was a sequence in the third quarter when Keenan ended up scoring a goal. There was about 3 hockey assists leading up to that. Just the well-balanced offense, how much do you guys trust each other to be able to whip it around?
Yeah, the trust on offense is just, like, everyone knows what everyone's going to do. We've all been playing for each other. Like, we've all been playing with each other for about 2-3 years. Like, a lot of us were on varsity as a freshman, so gotten to grow with each other, and we know that, like, we're getting a pass, it's going to be right on the stick, so we can just move one more, shoot if we have to. So it's just all about executing those tight little passes, and then if you can do that, you can just put up a lot of goals in the game.
You mentioned the two Howard County teams that you played early in the season that were kind of big games for you early on. Mm-hmm. The new schedule was obviously a fresh thing for you guys this year, especially this year and going forward. How much did that help you guys prepare to make this run?
Well, I think it was great. Compared to last year, we played Broadneck, I think, twice, and South River 3 times. I think it's great to go outside of the county. It's great for both counties to see what's going on before we get to this state here. And I just thought it was awesome. What can I say? I mean, whoever came up with that idea, it was a good one.
Ethan, what's different about this year's team then? Past teams that were talented that didn't get to where you guys are at now?
I'd have to say the work ethic and the passion that everyone has had this year. I've been on 2 state championship teams, this one and one with soccer, and when you're on a state championship team, you kind of know it from, like, the first day. There's always a different feel, like, in practice. Everyone just knows that the limit is put so high, and so that just kind of pushes everybody. And so this was one of those teams, so everyone knew that we had the potential to win states. And if we didn't win, it was basically going to be a failed season. That's what we kept telling each other, like, in huddles and stuff. It was like, we put in all the work so far, but if we don't win this game, then it means nothing. So this is the mentality we had all year, and we got us here.
The student section, this is really for all of you, the fans, they have some unique ways of showing their love to you guys. But